Father, we thank you, O Lord, who have assembled us again this day. We worship, honor, and adore thy excellency. We say, be thou exalted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
As we are about to hear your word, O Lord, descend to lead us. We cover this message with the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
We cover your churches worldwide with the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
We cover your children worldwide with the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
In Jesus Christ's holy name we pray.
Amen.
The title of our message is Christ Jesus is my helper. Amen.
Amen.
We as believers and followers of Christ Jesus, we need to depend upon the help of the Most High God. Christ is the only power that can deliver us from every ugly situation, and the only power that can help us as we live on earth. Praise the living God.
Amen.
If you don't mind and you're having your Bible, please turn with me to the book of Psalm. Psalm chapter 146. I'm reading from verse 3. Psalm 146 and verse 3 says, put not your trust in princes, nor in the son of man, in whom there is no help. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And the scripture is encouraging each and every one of us. And it says, put not your trust in the kings of this world. Put not your trust in the princes of this world. Don't depend upon the rich ones of this world. Help comes from the Most High God. No power can help you without the help and approval of the Most High God. And the psalmist continued cautioning weak believers. Put not your trust upon a man of your time. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And he proceeds to say, there is no help in a man. A man may intend to help you, but without the help and approval of the Most High God, that help can never come true. And that was why the book of Jeremiah chapter 17 says, curse unto them that depend upon men for help. And the book of Isaiah chapter 31 says, stop depending upon the nobles of this world, for there is no help in them. I proceed to verse 4. And it says, his breath goeth forth, he returneth to his earth, in that very day his thoughts perish. The day that they promise you help, the man who has promised that help may not see that day. This is why we don't need to depend upon any man for help. He says, because we must surely perish and go back to the dust. But the only man that will make a promise to you and bring that promise to manifestations is the Most High God, who has made heaven and the earth. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And verse 5 proceeds to say, happy is he that hath the God of Jacob for his help, whose hope is in the Lord his God. Happy is that man that depends and trusts upon the living God. Help comes from the living God. Solutions comes from the living God. And the scripture says, happy are those that have depend upon the God that will help them. The God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel. And verse 6 says, he is the maker of the heavens and the earth, the waters and all we are seeing. This is why it is advisable for we to depend and hope upon the living God. To start seeking help from the living God. Stop seeking help from men. No man can help you. Only the living God can help you in any situation and any circumstances. As I told you last week, Jonah was in a horrific situation. In the depth of the sea, in the belly of a well, he depended upon the living God, who can make that journey to the bottom of the sea and deliver him. And in Jonah chapter 2, Jonah says, I will continue looking upon the sanctuary of the Most High God, the spiritual sanctuary of the Most High God. For my help will surely come from God. And God heard him. And God helped him out. Praise and thank God.
Amen.
It is applicable to I and you to go back to God, God, who can help. Praise and thank God.
Amen.
If you don't mind, still turn with me to the book of 1 Peter to see the advice of the elect of the Most High God. 1 Peter chapter 2, I'm reading from verse 6. And he says, wherefore, also it is contained in the scripture, behold, I lay in Zion a chief cornerstone, elect, precious, and he that believeth on him shall not be confounded. And in the days of Peter, he's encouraging the believers and the world entirely. He says, as the scripture has indicated, God has elected just one man. God has elected just one man. I said, he is a trusted cornerstone, precious, elect of the Most High God, that whosoever that believe in him, in that situation, in that ugly situation, in that hopelessness, in that threat, in that situation, he says, any man that believe in him will never be put to shame. That man is Christ Jesus. This is why it is important for we, at first, try to understand who is your maker. Understand the power and ability in the Most High God. Go to God in prayers. And there is no way you will receive solution and help without prayers. As I told the church last night, we have been struggling with lots of difficulties without solution. Because we cannot pray. The simple fact is that we cannot pray. But in the days of the apostles of Christ, they were able to perform great things because they can pray. God cannot help you without hearing your voice. This is why prayer is important. And before the crucifixion of our Lord Jesus Christ, he cautioned his disciples. He says, watch and pray for you to receive help, for you to overcome, for you to receive the miracles of your life. Praise the name of God.
Amen.
If you don't mind, still talk with me to the book of Hebrews to see the word of encouragement to all believers. Hebrews chapter 13, I'm reading from verse 6, and it says, so that we may boldly say, the Lord is my helper, and I will not fear. What man shall do unto me? And when Paul was writing to the Hebrews, he says, I will boldly proclaim my faith. A believer needs to boldly proclaim his faith. Take a solid stand upon your faith. Who is your master? Whom do you want to follow? Whom do you want to worship? And so Paul says, personally for him, he will boldly stand upon the living God to emphasize the greatness and power of the Most High God, that he will never be put to fear, no matter the circumstances. Because the Lord is there with him, he says, the Most High God is my helper, and it is applicable to I and you. Take a bold stand with your maker and boldly proclaim that God is your helper in that ugly situation. No matter the land where you are, the land doesn't mean. No matter the circumstances, no matter the evil people that have surrounded you, if the Lord is your helper, you don't need to panic. Praise the name of God.
Amen.
Talk with me to the book of Genesis. Let's consider the first step that Jacob took before God came to help him. Genesis chapter 28. I'm reading from verse 20. And he says, And Jacob vowed a vow, saying, if God will be with me, and will keep me in this way that I go, and will give me bread to eat, and raiment to put on. Praise and thank God.
Amen.
Before God will come into your situation, or before God will come very close to you, you must take the appropriate steps towards God. When Jacob was on a hopeless journey, when he was being filled with fear, the first thing he did was this. Along his journey, he decided to start consulting the Most High God. He knew that God alone can see him through. He knew quite well that his father cannot intervene in such a situation. At first, he vowed unto the living God to come into his life in the first place. He decided to embrace God fully. He made four prayers. In the first place, he asked God, if you shall be with me. He knew that the journey would be very difficult. He knew that along the line, there must be storms, obstacles, temptations, perhaps failures. He consulted God to be with him in the first place. In the second place, he said, if God will go with him, as I keep telling you all, you cannot succeed by your efforts. No matter how talented you are, no matter how composed you are, no matter how strong you are, you cannot succeed by your personal efforts or qualities. And he says, if you shall go with me on this journey. And in the third place, he says, if you will provide for me, our help is in God. The help of true believers is in God. God who can do all things. We call him the omnipotent God. Because he has the power to do all things. And men cannot do all things. Our power as men are highly limited. But the power of the Most High God is not limited. I said, if you will provide for me to eat. And in the fourth place he says, if you shall clothe me. He made his supplications to the living God, not to any man. I proceed to verse 21. And he says, so that I come again to my father's house in peace, then shall the Lord be my God. It is important. Before you have much intimacy with God, you must come closer to God. You must commit those fears into the hands of God. And he said to God, if you shall take me and bring me back home safely. So many of us have made that journey, but we couldn't make it back home safely. Because God is not there to support us. God is not there to protect us. So many of us have made that journey, and we made it back home, but without any achievements. We couldn't achieve anything because God is not there for us. But Jacob says, if you shall be with me, when I go and comes back home safely, when I'm being blessed, you shall be my God. A believer needs to make a decision of God to worship. God has given us the ability to know the right from the wrong, to make a choice on where to be. And he said, if God, if you will do this to me, you will be my God. I proceed to verse 22. And this stone which I have set for a pillar shall be God's house. And of that thou shalt give me, I will surely give the tenth unto thee. Tithe is important. I'm not condemning tithe. Before God will answer you in certain situation, make promise to God. Tithe is important. We have the less privileged in our society. We have the orphans in our society. We have the widows in our society. And these people are people that affect God. All their tears goes to God. And Jacob decided to make a promise to God. if you shall make me to be successful, I will come back with one tenth of these blessings unto thee. Your tithe doesn't tell you to take it to the church or take it to any man. Take it to the fatherless, to the orphans in our society. Take it to the widows in our societies. Take it to the less privileged in our society. Make those that are handicapped to rejoice as well. God has given us the opportunity to be fit. It is by the grace of God. God has made us equally as He has made those that are handicapped. What is your effort to make those people to rejoice? And this is the most important thing that accompanies prayers. Before your prayer will be answered, you need basic steps. Jacob knew that the journey would be very difficult for him. A journey that he had nobody that will stand on his defense. He decided to consult the maker of heaven and the earth. And God helped him. God heard his prayers. Praise and thank God.
Amen.
If you don't mind that you are still having your Bible, please turn with me to the book of Psalm. Psalm chapter 72, I'm reading from verse 12, and it says, "For he shall deliver the needy when he crieth, the poor also, and him that hath no helper. And the psalmist is enlightening we. The Most High God will listen to you when you cry unto him." When you take the appropriate steps like Jacob, Jacob was in need. Jacob was poor. Jacob was alone. But he realized that the reliable help will come from the Most High God. He cried unto that God. And the book of Psalms is telling I and you, God is willing to hear our prayers. The prayers of the needy, those that are being oppressed, those that are in sorrowful situation, God will always hear their prayers. And verse 13 proceeds to say, "He shall spare the poor and needy, and shall save the souls of the needy." Praise the name God.
Amen.
And the scripture says, "When the poor and needy cry unto the living God, he will save you from the reproach of men. He will save you from the catastrophic calamities that is on your way. He will save you from the wrath of men." Praise the name of God.
Amen.
This is why it is advisable and vitally important for each every one of us. Make God your helper. Depend upon the living God who has not failed and who will never fail. God has not failed and will never fail for all eternity. And the people of old, they realized this fact. And they were strong in the Most High God. And God helped them in their land and helped them in strange land. It is advisable for you, since you are in a strange land, where you have got no helper, nobody tells you what is the truth in the land where you are, it is advisable for you to come to the Most High God. Make God your helper for you to be helped in that land. And in that situation, praise the name of God.
Amen.
If you don't mind, please sit on with me to the book of Genesis to see the account of the journey of Jacob. Genesis chapter 31. I'm reading from verse 29. And it says, "It is in the power of my hand to do you hurt. But the God of your father spake unto me yesternight, saying, Take thou heed that thou speak not to Jacob, either good or bad." Praise the name God.
Amen.
Why we need God as our helper is this. Men are filled with evil, according to the book of Genesis chapter 6. He said, "The days of men were being filled with evil, right from our youth days." And in the case of Jacob, when God decided to be with him, whatsoever he was doing, they were all successful. And the house of Laban was blessed for the sake of Jacob. But because we have evil men in the society, we have evil men in the churches, we have evil men in the family. This is why we need to depend on God. And when Jacob have served Laban for 20 years, he decided to go. To go back home according to his vision. The prayer he made to God in the book of Genesis chapter 28 is this: if you shall be with me in this journey, if I will make this journey and go back home safely. And he believed it is high time for him to go back home safely. These 20 years have been filled with cheating, with tears, with troubles. But Laban refused that Jacob will not go back home safely. He plotted evil against Jacob. He decided to eliminate him. He started chasing him. But the same God that he has consulted from the beginning of his journey, that God was there. And that God decided to intercept that ugly situation. And God went to Laban at night and called him and says, "Do not evil to Jacob. Speak neither good or bad to him, or else I will rise against you." And this became the fear of Laban. And this became the success of Jacob. This is why we need God in our life. In our days, we need God. And regardless of where you are, and regardless of the situation, you need God. God is the only reliable answer and help towards your life. I proceed to verse 41. And verse 41 says, Thus have I been 20 years in thy house. I served thee 14 years for thy two daughters, and 6 years for thy cattle, and thou hast changed my wages 10 times. When we see evil people in our days, we have been seeing them from the days of old. According to the word of God, he says, men are being filled of evil. We have been filled of evil. They made agreements Laban could not keep to the agreement. He served for his younger daughter, he gave him the older daughter. He served a second 7 years before the younger daughter could be given to him. But yet, Laban claims these are his own. He's not considering the service of Jacob. He's not considering the hard work of Jacob. The full 7 years for each daughter, all are for Laban, not for Jacob. We still have similar people in our generation. You can see them anywhere. They are there in the churches. They are there in the community. They are there in the families. But you need God to fight for you in such a situation. He served him for extra 6 years for his cattle. The wages were being changed. The agreement was being changed for 10 times or more than 10 times. We see people like that. In our homeland, we see people like that. When we see lots of suffering in our homeland, those sufferings are being made of men, not of God. But you need God to come and speak for you in such an ugly situation. Praise and thank God. Amen. I proceed to verse 42. And he said, "Except the God of my father, the God of Abraham, and the fear of Isaac have been with me, surely thou hast sent me away now empty. God has seen my affliction and and the labor of my hands and rebuked thee yesternight." Praise and thank God.
Amen.
Only God knows your affliction. What you are passing through, only God knows it. What you are passing through, only one man can change that ugly situation. That man is God. All the evil plans against your life, only God can wave them away from their ways. And Jacob says, "If not for the help of the God of Abraham and Isaac, you would have sent me away empty." But God says, "No." This is why we need God in our days. more especially in the land where we are. We need divine intervention of the Most High God in the land where we are. And verse 43 says, and Laban answered and said unto Jacob, these daughters are my daughters, and these children are my children, and these cattle are my cattle, and all that thou seest is mine. And what can I do this day unto these my daughters, or unto their children, which they have born? When you see a wicked man, a man who is not God-fearing, their sense of reasoning is always negative. A man who has married your daughters, a man who has served you, you have wiped away all his labor, and you continue claiming that all this belongs to you. We have such people in our generation. When you see such people, what you need to do is to depend upon God. When you are in that ugly situation of hopelessness, come to Jesus, who can fix that situation, who can help you in the midst of your enemies. Only God makes our enemies to make a mistake to bless us. It comes by the power of the Most High God. That God is dependable. And that God is the God that Jacob covenanted with. You must be in a strong covenant with your God. You must dedicate your life to your God. You must decide to follow God wholeheartedly. In the book of Joshua, it says, this God is a jealous God. The Most High God is a jealous God. According to the book of Joshua chapter 24, he says, when you go out from the ways of God to follow other gods, God will be angry with you and God will depart from you. And this is why it is important for me to make a proper decision on whom to serve. But personally for me, I've decided to follow the living God, who can help in any situation and circumstances and the places where you are. Praise the living God. If you still have the Bible, please turn with me to the book of Isaiah to see the promises of the Most High God. Isaiah chapter 63. I'm reading from verse 9. If you are there, say amen.
Amen.
And he says, in all their affliction, he was afflicted, and the angel of his presence saved them. In his love and in his pity, he redeemed them, and he bare them, and carried them all the days of old. Only God can do that in our cases. And the scripture says, God says the living God, in their afflictions, God has been afflicted instantly. And he decided to send forth his angels of miracles. As in that burning furnace, remember that the angel of God appeared and he made them the fourth man in that fire and protected the children of God. Remember in the Red Sea, the angel of God appeared as a pillar of fire by night and as a pillar of cloud by day to protect the children of God. And the scripture says, in our affliction, God is afflicted, and he sent forth these great angels to help us. Come to Jesus, who can help. We can never receive help from any power. Every other power in this world is limited. But one power is reliable and dependable. That power is the power of the Most High God. Praise the name of God.
Amen.
Still talk with me to the book of Micah to see the word of encouragement unto we believers. Micah chapter 7, I'm reading from verse 7. And he says, therefore, I will look unto the Lord. I will wait for the God of my salvation. My God will hear me. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And prophet Micah says, I will look unto the living God, the God of my salvation, the God that can salvage, because help comes from the Most High God alone. And he's encouraging each and every one of us. upon that God. Wait patiently upon that God. Don't go into sinful ways. Don't go into sinful ways because you need an instant solution towards your problems. Never. Don't do that. The children of God will call upon the God who is able and wait patiently for that God to do it at the right time. He says, I know my salvation cometh from this God. When God is with you, when the Most High God is with you, you cannot be killed easily. No matter the amount of evil that is existing in the land where you are, no matter the amount of evil men that have compassed you, they cannot lay hand on you. Just as in the case of Jacob, Laban and his men had evil intention on Jacob, but God was his helper, and God intervened in such an ugly situation. Over your family, the only reliable help will come from the Most High God. What you might have been passing through in your family, I don't know. But one thing is sure, only God can fix those problems in your family. Only God can stabilize the peace and unity of your family. Have you been suffering from disappointments and failure? Only God can bring your disappointment to be an appointment. Only God can bring your curses to be a blessing. And that is why you need to depend upon that God. Have you been hopeless all the days of your life? Only the Most High God can transform your hopelessness into hope. And the scripture says, I will continue looking upon that God. I will continue waiting upon that God. For I know my solution comes from that God, who will never fail. Our God will never fail. As I told you earlier, God has not failed. From the history of creation, God has not failed. And to this day, God has not failed. And to all eternity, God will never fail. God is the only power that can never fail. And the people of old, they realized the great power in the Most High God. And they went into God fully. They did not call God half and half, like we, the men of this generation. We refuse to follow God wholeheartedly. We refuse to follow the idols of our land. And we are being caught in the mix. And it seems as if to say there is no solution with God. Before you have solution from God, depend upon that God. When I see people that went into witchcraft, into occultism, into gods of nations, into idols of nations for protection, I became so sorrowful of their belief. The only power that can protect you, the only power that can help you, the only power that can give you victory, in regardless of where you are, is the Most High God. The witches cannot give you protection. Their powers are highly limited. The powers of marine world can do nothing in your life. Nothing good will come from these powers. But the Most High God alone is the God that will do you favor, no matter where you are, no matter how hopeless you are. That God transforms hopelessness of his children to be hopefulness. Praise that name, God.
Amen.
If you don't mind, still talk with me to the book of Isaiah chapter 54. Isaiah chapter 54, I'm reading from verse 4. And he says, fear not, for thou shalt not be ashamed, neither be thou confounded, for thou shalt not be put to shame, for thou shalt forget the shame of thy youth, and shalt not remember the reproach of thy widowhood anymore. And when God was speaking through Isaiah the prophet, as I told you, Isaiah is one of my beloved prophets from the scripture. He says, those that depend on God, those that have taken refuge in God, God says they will never be put to shame. neither shall they be confounded. He came back again to make a solid promise again. You will never be put to shame. If God is your helper, he says you will never be put to shame. And he will clean off the shame of your youth days. The shame and reproach of your widowhood shall be erased. People might have condemned you. People might have said different things about your life. People might have asked you, who is your helper? People might have been saying, let us see who will survive him. And God says he will come into that situation to prove them wrong, take away your reproach, and make you a happy man for all eternity. Praise that name, God.
Amen.
And verse 5 says, for thy maker is thy husband, the Lord of hosts is his name, and thy Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel, the God of the whole earth, shall he be called. Who can battle with the Most High God? Which power can challenge the power of the Most High God? I've not seen that power. I've not known of that power. The only power that can visit you, he says, when I come into that situation, your widowhood shall be erased. He will become your husband. A husband that will bring joy into your life. Prosperity will follow. Protection will follow. Success will follow. Peace will come into your life. Favor and blessings will come into all you are doing. That power is the Most High God. This will be the end of our message. My encouragement to each and every one of you is this. Hope upon the living God firmly. Don't shake when you are with God. No matter what you are passing through, I know you have passed through a lot. But come back to that God who will miraculously fix all your broken bones. May God bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.